हेलो एवरीवन, नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द हिप बोन सेपरेटली. सो हिप बोन इज अ फ्लैट इरेगुलर बोन एंड एज आई टोल्ड अर्लियर दिस बोन इज फॉर्म्ड बाय द फ्यूजन ऑफ थ्री बोन्स इलियम, इशियम एंड पिवस. इफ यू सी द bone grossly, you can see the upper expanded part and lower expanded part and middle constricted part. There is a fossa, cup-shaped fossa present in the outer aspect of middle constricted part. This fossa is known as acetabulum. And below to this fossa, there is a foramen known as obturator foramen. The pubic bone lies anteromedial to this foramen. This is pubic bone, and ischium lies posterior to this foramen. Now we have to determine the side of the hip bone. Which side does this belong? To determine this, we have to hold the hip bone such that the acetabulum directed outward and anterior superior iliac spine, and this is pubic tubercle. Anterior superior iliac spine and pubic tubercle should lie in same coronal plane. So like this. So this is the right hip bone, and you should keep this bone in such a way that these two, anterior superior iliac spine and pubic tubercle, should lie in same coronal plane, and ischial tuberosity should be the lowest point. If you hold this like this, then pubic bone is the lowest point. So hold like this. This is the right hip, so hold in the right hand like this. Sorry. Like this you can hold. Now we'll study about the ilium in detail. Ilium having two ends, upper end and lower end. This is lower end. This is upper end. Two borders, anterior border, posterior border. Three surfaces, outer gluteal surface, inner iliac fossa, and this is sacropelvic surface. So there are three borders. One border is left, anterior border, posterior border, and another one is medial border. You can see medial border from here to iliopubic eminence, and this border separates iliac fossa and sacropelvic surface. If you see the gluteal surface, we can see three ridges which starts from the greater sciatic notch. This ridge is known as posterior gluteal line. This ridge is known as anterior gluteal line, and this ridge is known as inferior gluteal line. Behind this gluteal line, gluteal maximus takes origin. Between the posterior gluteal line and anterior gluteal line, gluteus medius muscle takes origin. Between the anterior gluteal line and inferior gluteal line, gluteus minimus muscle gluteus minimus muscle takes origin. So this is about the gluteal surface. This is iliac fossa. Iliacus muscle takes origin from this surface. Now we study about the upper end. Upper end, this is upper end of the, which is known as iliac crest. It starts from the anterior superior iliac spine and ends in posterior superior iliac spine. This iliac crest divided into the ventral 2/3 and dorsal 1/3. Ventral 2/3, as you can see, is convex outward, and dorsal 1/3 is convex inward. The ventral 2/3 of the iliac crest is divided into outer lip area, intermediate area, and inner lip. And the dorsal segment is divided into outer sloping area and inner sloping area. Now you see the anterior border. Anterior border starts from the anterior superior iliac spine and ends in the acetabulum. There is a notch in the upper part, and below this notch there is a elevation which is known as anterior inferior iliac spine. In the upper part of anterior inferior iliac spine, straight head of rectus femoris takes origin, and in the lower aspect, apex of the iliofemoral ligament attaches. Posterior border starts from the posterior superior iliac spine and ends in the at the point where it fuses with the ischium. This is the point where it fuses with the ischium, and there is also elevation in the upper part. This is known as posterior inferior iliac spine, and there is a notch present posterior aspect. This is known as greater sciatic notch. Between the inferior gluteal line and acetabulum, in this area, reflected head of rectus femoris takes origin. Straight head from this area and reflected head from this area. Now we see there is another elevation in the outer lip. This is anterior superior iliac spine, and 5 cm behind the anterior superior iliac spine, there is another elevation. This is known as tubercle of iliac crest. Between anterior superior iliac spine and tubercle of iliac crest, in the outer lip, tensor fasciae latae is the muscle origin takes place from this area, outer lip, between anterior superior iliac spine and tubercle of iliac crest. This is tubercle of iliac crest. In the inner aspect, you are seeing the iliopubic eminence. This iliopubic eminence is the point of fusion between the ilium and pubic bone. This is medial border, start from the iliac crest, and this is smooth part of the medial border. From here, rough part to the iliopubic eminence is known as arcuate line. This medial border separates the iliac fossa to the sacropelvic surface. This rough one is sacral part, and this is pelvic part. This sacral surface having the tuberosity, this is known as iliac tuberosity. And just below this, there is a auricular area. articular area. This is the articular area which joins with the sacrum and forms the sacroiliac joint. This is known as tubercle of iliac crest, iliac tuberosity, and this is the auricular area. And this is the smooth part of pelvic surface which continues with the surface of the ilium.